What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the Journey Podcast. I have a really exciting episode today because we are going to talk about how to make more money in life, not just more money in your business, but more money for yourself. Now, I did not learn how to manage my money from my parents. I did not learn how to manage my money from school. I had to learn on my own. My goal when I was very young, about 16, 17, 18, was that I wanted to be a millionaire. Like, that was my number one goal. When people said, like, what do you want to do when you grow up? I said, I want to be a millionaire. And so I took it upon myself to learn about personal finance. I took it about upon myself to learn how to manage my money. And I feel like I've done a pretty damn good job at that. And so what I want to do is relate those habits and disciplines and kind of pass that information down to you guys, because I want you guys to manage more money. Now, I'm going to share what I've learned through the steps that I took in my own life to get to where I am today financially. And then you guys can kind of place yourself on that spectrum and on that timeline to figure out where you are and what you need to do in order for you to make more money today. Now, I am going to start this off, back when I was 17, 18, literally starting with a ground zero. Like, I think I maybe had $1,000 or $2,000 saved up from, washing my uncle's cars and also, like mowing my neighbor's lawns, and then also saved up from like Christmas and like birthday monies. Now, I'm going to admit, I grew up in a very privileged situation. We weren't rich by any means, but my parents did have dual income. Like, both my parents worked 9 to 5s. They both made close to 6 figures, and they provided a stable house home for me, my brother, and my sister to grow up in. So that is something that I know that not a lot of people have, and I want to take a moment to highlight that. And it also is something that I really appreciate, because I don't want to take those kinds of things for granted. But other than that, I pretty much started from zero. So my parents provided a house home and a stable foundation for me to launch off of, but other than that, I started with zero. And I started, working in the sense of I worked on my worked at my uncle's house on the weekends to wash cars. And that's kind of where I got like my first couple $1,000s. And I just spent that money on books, learning about personal finance, et cetera, et cetera. Now, the one thing that I understood is that if I wanted to be a millionaire, then I needed to be saving money, right? That was the first thing that I understood, is that I cannot be a millionaire if I'm broke and if I don't have money. But the thing is, I wasn't making very much money at all. Like, at this point, I didn't even have a job. I wasn't making an income. I just knew that if I wanted to make money, then I needed to save money, or I needed to, first get an income. So I started a business where it didn't require me to make a ton of investment. It was a service-based business, which is personal training. And so all I had to do is invest my time in order for me to make an income. But the thing was, I wasn't making a ton of money, right? So I got another job. So now I had 2 sources of income. I was bussing tables and I was a personal trainer. So now I had income coming in. The thing I understood was that I'm not making a ton of money, and so I need to be saving money, right? I should not be spending all of this money. So I made a decision to live at my parents' house for as long as I possibly could, until it just didn't make sense for me to live there anymore. But what that allowed me to do was decrease my expenses so I can increase my savings, right? It's really hard to move quickly in life if you don't have money. So the number one thing to do is to save the money that you're making, so that way when an opportunity presents itself, you can invest that money to save yourself time and make more money. And we'll talk about what that looks like later in this training. But that's pretty much where I started. Now, when I moved out of my parents' house, I was making a little bit more money. I wasn't making a ton. I was making a couple $1,000s, which in San Diego and in California just isn't that much. And so I knew that I had to be very smart and very careful with the money that I was making. There was not a single month in my life where I spent more money than I saved. Every single month that I've ever lived, I have saved money. My bank account has grown. Not because I made a ton of money, not because I worked harder than anybody else, but it was because in the very beginning, the only options that I had was to decrease the amount of money that I was spending. So I was shopping at discount grocery stores. I was shopping at discount thrift stores. I was barely buying clothes for myself. I was shopping at the cheapest gas. I had no car payment. I was driving a shit beater car because I didn't want a car payment. I was sleeping in a sharing a bedroom with a roommate in a house of five guys. I was doing everything I could to pinch as many dollars as I could so I can save money. And then, you know, I even moved to Virginia to sleep on the, in the basement of this dude's house for free, in order for myself to save money. So that probably took me about 2, 3, 4 years of just saving, you know, a couple hundred bucks a month, and just really being dedicated to saving as much money as possible. Then what happened was once I had about $10,000 saved up, which again, took me a very long time. But once I had like $10,000 saved up, I felt like, okay, I finally feel like I have a little bit of money saved up to where I can take risks on myself and invest in myself. And then, you know, make a little bit more money. So now that I had a nest egg that I can work with, I understood that if I want to be a millionaire, then I need to make more money. And I knew that I wasn't going to make more money bussing tables. I needed a new opportunity for me to make more money. And for me, that opportunity was online coaching. So the thing is the first step, if you want to be rich, is that you need to build a nest egg of savings. And in order to do that, you need to decrease the amount of money that you're spending and increase the amount of money that you're saving. Personally, the more money you can save, the faster you'll build that nest egg, the faster you'll be able to be successful. So it really does take discipline to, like, I guess, resist the urges of spending money, going out all the time and buying the nicest things. Yes, you will have a nice life, but you're also going to be broke if you do that and you just spend all the money that you have. So step number one is build yourself a nest egg of savings to where you can use that to reinvest it into yourself. Now, what I would say is that if you want to make more money and you want to, I guess, be a millionaire, it's not about how much you can save, but it's about how much cash flow you can earn each month, right? I didn't really understand this until, you know, a couple of years ago, but I always thought that if I just saved more money, then I'll be rich, right? Or rich quicker, I guess. But that's like really the slow way. Saving money is really, really slow. Like I mentioned, it took me 2 to 3 years to save up $10,000. And so it's really slow. And then with interest rates, you know, the value of the dollar is now decreasing. And so if you're just saving money, then you're taking a really slow approach. And also the value of the money is decreasing. So what you're saving is no longer as valuable as it once was at the time you saved it. And so what I learned was that you need to reinvest that money back into yourself and increase the amount of money that you earn each month. That was the big kicker for me, is that it wasn't that I needed to spend less and less and just save. It was that I needed to take what I was saving, reinvest it into myself, and earn more money each month. And what that looked like was starting a coaching business where I can then help more people, charge more, and make more than a dollar per hour amount. And so that's pretty much what happened. I went from making $2,000-$3,000 a month to $4,000-$5,000 per month. But with keeping the same living expenses down pretty low, I was then able to save an extra grand each month, which was able to grow my savings even more so. Right. And then what would happen was I would take those earnings, reinvest it again back into myself. And when I was reinvesting, I'm talking about hiring mentors and hiring coaches and hiring, you know, taking certifications to increase my skill. Because if I were to take a certification, invest into myself, take a certification, I am now more knowledgeable and qualified. I have more authority on a certain space. Now I can, you know, charge more or be more of authority for people to hire me as a coach, et cetera, et cetera. And so that money is going to come back. And so, you know, it's about putting that money back into yourself and increasing your earning potential and then being able to earn more each month, but also keeping your living expenses low. And that was pretty much the cycle for, you know, 1 to 2 years, to where I would earn more, put it back into myself, earn more, put it back into myself. And that's pretty much how you build a business. It's all about cash flow. So I want you guys to like drill that into your head, because it was a big light bulb that went off in my mind, like, you know, 1 to 2 years ago, that is that if you want to get rich and you want to be a millionaire, it is not about how much you save and not about, you know, how long you save for. And it's more about how like much monthly income you can earn for yourself. Because if you can get that monthly income higher and higher and higher, you're going to be able to save more each month and then also reinvest that each month. And then also, you know, get there much, much quicker. And so I see a lot of people who are making, you know, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, and they're living off of, let's say that they're making $4,000 a month and they're living off of $3,000 a month, and they only have $1,000 left over to save. And they're scared to invest in themselves because they want to hold on to that $1,000 per month. What I would do in that situation is I would take that $4,000 and take that $3,000 of living expenses, figure out how can I possibly get these living expenses as low as possible? What do I need to do, and what can I let go of in order to make the $3,000 living expenses down to $2,500 or $2,250 or $2,000? And I know all you guys think it probably sounds crazy to live off of $2,000 a month, but it is fucking possible. You can move in with your parents' house. You can move in with a friend. You can get a really shitty apartment somewhere in a shit part of town. You can make these sacrifices for yourself in order to increase the amount that you're able to put away. And then once you maximize how much you could put away each month, then you want to take what you're saving and reinvest that into yourself to figure out, how can I earn more each month, right? How can I put this savings and then use that to, you know, start a business, or, you know, increase your skills to increase your capacity to help more people. Now that's a different topic in and of itself, but that's pretty much the concept here. You want to be able to maximize your monthly income by starting a business, or, you know, providing a service of some sort, or just increasing your ability to earn more each month. Then once you're earning more each month, you're going to be able to save at a faster rate. You'll be able to invest at a faster rate. And if you can continue investing back into yourself to earn more each month, dude, you are going to be like, you're going to be well off for life. I don't even know how to put it into words. Like, you'll be set. So that's pretty much the way to get rich, right? Save your money, reinvest that money back into yourself, and then use that investment into yourself to learn how you can earn more each month. Honestly, the best way that I've found to do it is to start a business for yourself and just reinvest back into your business and reinvest back into your capacity to earn more each month, and make that the focus. Make that the focus is, how can I increase the amount of money that I earn each month while also keeping my living expenses low enough to where I'm profiting each month? So hopefully this one rang some bells for you guys. I know that was a big light bulb that went off for me when I first learned about it. And no one ever really taught me that. It was just something that I realized one day, and I wanted to pass it down to you guys. So take with it what you will. We'll catch you guys in the next episode. Peace.